Everybody, it's Lori with Reiki and Wellness, broadcasting from my healing space tonight for Wellness Wednesday. And this is the last week of November. Actually, I think today's the last day of November. And we're wrapping up our gratitude and forgiveness practice for this series of videos. And tonight, I want to basically work on something called radical forgiveness. It's a philosophy, and it's based on a book that I read many years ago when I was working on my healing in depth, and I really love the book. It really helped me a lot, and so I'm just going to kind of bring up some tips and pointers from the book tonight, plus do the energy work and the Buddhist practices. So I hope you enjoy it. And we just want to go ahead and start by cleansing our auric field again. And I'm using lavender and tangerine oil tonight. So lavender is calming. It's also the color purple, which is the gratitude color that I've selected. And combining them is very uplifting. So you just wanted to kind of take everything off your energy field again from the day, from the week. When you take the time to do this, it's really rebalancing and healthy for you. And don't forget your feet. So we have energy centers on our feet as well as in our hands, and that's why it's important to cleanse your feet and ground your feet whenever you can, because it's shifting the energy from the energy center. Just kind of let everything go. Relax, ground, and when you're ready to open your energy field, you want to start working with your crown chakra. Some of you will need to warm up your hands before you do this, so feel free to just warm up your hands and get some energy flowing between your hands before you start working with your other chakras. Now we're ready to open our energy field. So let's just do a check-in, see where we're at tonight. It's really, really, really important to work on your heart center when you're doing the gratitude and forgiveness practice and start to open it up as much as you can, because you want the work to penetrate, right? So if you're all closed down, it can't get in. So you want to really open as much as you can. Creating a safe space, creating a safe auric field for yourself to do this. It shouldn't be too difficult. But when we feel closed down, nothing can get through. So it's important to open, and especially our heart space as we're doing the gratitude and forgiveness practices. Just kind of play with the energy center and try to get it to open as much as you can. And then I want to start thinking of something we're really grateful for. Hopefully you guys had a nice holiday, or you have some vacations to look forward to coming up, or you know, maybe you're spending extra time with friends. Something you're really grateful for right now. And honestly, for me, I'm just feeling grateful that I get to spend time like this. I really needed it. I need extra time this week to just tune in and check in with myself too. So whatever you're feeling grateful for in this moment, And for anyone you're feeling grateful for, just start thinking of something to feel grateful for so we can open and expand our heart center. Okay. So working with an open heart is really important. And then we want to call in all the light so we can build and expand our center. So we want to call in divine light, divine love, universal life force energy. You can call on your angels, your guides, your higher self. This radical forgiveness topic, I think we want to bring in everything that we can. So start imagining all the supportive energy coming in down through your chakra and into your heart space and filling your heart space with all the light and the love and the good energy and the support. And just see if you can feel a shift as you call it all in. So open your energy field and call in all the light, the sun, the soft moonlight if you want. Just start playing with the different ranges of light, soft to bright, and see if that helps you shift anything. Call in your spiritual team if you like, your angels, your guides, your higher self. You can call in ancestors, anybody that you feel could help and assist you in this good work that you're doing tonight. And the good work that we're doing tonight is we're going to work on really attacking like some core forgiveness issues, even more than we have already. So that's the idea behind radical forgiveness. Calling in our spiritual team, feeling fortified and supported, and now we can feel safe to work on this issue and these issues that come up for us. So the idea in the Radical Forgiveness book is that before we're born, we actually kind of plan out our life. That's kind of what destiny is about. So when you think of destiny, it's something that's pre-planned or preordained for you and that you're going to come up to your destiny or meet your destiny at some point in your life, right? So there's a lot of spiritual concepts, reincarnation and anything in the New Age community talks about how we've all pre-planned or pre-scripted our life and we do have free will while we live the life, but we have some blueprints of how we're going to live and who we're gonna meet and what's gonna happen and what we're here to do. And really what we're here to learn. So a lot of spiritual philosophies or ideologies subscribe to the idea that we're learning and that Earth is a school and that we're here to learn and we're learning lessons or we're building strength in certain areas or we're, fulfilling our destinies in certain ways. But those ways can look like something bad that's happened to us. And because of that, we have a hard time moving on to what we really could learn from that experience or what we could really do with that experience and how that's really preparing us for a bigger, better destiny, because that's kind of how it all plays out. So we're here to learn lessons. We're here to work on issues and we're here to evolve. We're here to grow. We're here to learn. We're here to help. We're here to do a lot of things, but all of that's basically pre-scripted before we're born. And when we do that, you also put different people are teaching us lessons. So we have different teachers, and a lot of our teachers, according to radical forgiveness and other spiritual philosophies, are our parents, or our friends, or our children, or people close in our close circle. And sometimes those relationships have a lot of tension in them, right? Or a lot of strife or conflict or, even abuse or different things that are painful. And we will also encounter different things in our life that are painful. And that pain is leading us to something else. So the idea in radical forgiveness is to look at everything from a larger perspective and think about if that's true, if all of this was pre-designed, preordained, if the conflict I'm having with this other person is for a reason and that we came together to work it out, or we're going to learn lessons around this, or we're going to overcome the situation, or we just have to actually forgive each other. You know, that could be the whole lesson right there. But anyways, it's proposing that everything happens for a reason, that everyone in your life is there for a reason, and that all the circumstances are there to help you get on the path towards your destiny, or they are part of your destiny, or they're part of your lesson plan, or they're part of your soul growth, or they're part of your evolution and your awakening, and all, you know, it's just part of the plan. So even the hard stuff. And so that's really, I think when you look at everything like that, you think, okay, yeah, these are hard lessons with different people, and some people are more challenging than others. But the idea is that it's really based in love, essentially, because when you guys, you know, incarnated together, you chose to play these roles with each other. And when you go back to being a soul and a spirit, you're gonna, you know, kind of talk it all out and maybe come back again in other roles. So we're really just kind of acting in other people's lives as a teacher or a guide or a villain or whatever it is. And that if you can take that perspective, you can kind of start to loosen your grip on how you are having a hard time with that person. So basically, how I want to approach tonight is start thinking about somebody who played a big role in your life that maybe was the villain, right? So maybe you had a villain in your life and they did a really good job at their villain role, and it caused you a lot of pain and it caused you a lot of hurt. And I want you to start to imagine that that person actually came in to help you. So if this is all true, if radical forgiveness is based in some type of reality, if this is actually true, that even the villains in our life are there to help us, how did this villain possibly help you? So I want us to kind of sit with this for a second and think about maybe five things that they did that actually helped you on your journey so far. Okay, so maybe five things that might have hurt you but actually ended up helping you later. And if you can't come up with five, come up with two. And just start to think about like how they actually have assisted you in your destiny, or assisted you on your life path, or assisted you in growing or healing, or, you know, how did they set you on a course that actually improved your life? So let's think about that for a couple minutes and just sit with that and just think about it for a second. And sometimes we learn in opposite ways, right? So if we have bad examples, maybe we're the type of person who learns best from bad examples of how not to be. Maybe we learn like that and we got some bad examples to show us how we didn't want to be, because that would be the better way for us to learn. So think of things like that too. Like maybe this was all, you know, really designed well to help you learn and grow and evolve and change. So think of something like that too. Just like maybe, you know, if you got all cushy things, you wouldn't have had anything rubbing against you to make you force you out into the world to go and learn and do other things, you know. Okay, so hopefully you have the person in mind. Hopefully you've thought of some things that they did to help you. inadvertently help you, right? They didn't mean to. I mean, ultimately they meant to help you, but in this life it felt like they were, giving you a hard time. So now what I'd like to do is the exercise of where we just say thank you. We say thank you for showing up for me. I know this role has been hard for you to play. And if we can say that like three times to this person, it's going to break up some energy. So let's just say thank you for showing up for me. I know this role has been hard for you to play. Thank you for showing up for me. I know this role has been hard for you to play. Thank you for showing up for me. I know this role has been hard for you to play. And just kind of take it a couple steps further. I appreciate you showing up for me in my life. I know we're here to learn, and I know that ultimately this has helped me. Thank you for showing up for me. I know we're all here to learn, and ultimately this has helped me. Thank you for showing up for me. We are all here to learn, and ultimately this has helped me. So, if you want to read the book Radical Forgiveness, he goes through a lot of different scenarios and stories and weaves a lot of different situations throughout the book that actually ultimately led to, good outcomes based on adversity. So, it's a really good book. It's very inspiring. And it would be worth reading, especially if you want to work on more forgiveness. It's good to get really deep with this stuff because once you attack it and once you get down to the root of things, you can actually set yourself free. And when you set yourself free, you just maintain it. You just, if little things come up, you just start releasing those. But once you get the big stuff down and you handle it and you let it go, you just feel so much better, and it's really worth the effort. And it can take a while sometimes. It just depends on your situation and what's happened. It can take a little while, but I promise that once you get through it all, you actually do feel free and you are like a whole person again because you're just carrying around all these sacks of, feelings and issues, and once you let it all go, you can just kind of like step into your destiny even further and get further on your path. And I feel like all of this healing work just brings us closer to who we're meant to be. And so that's why I care about it so much, and that's why I care that you might want to work on it too, because I think it would be wonderful if we all felt so good. And this is a great way to feel good and to work on things and to also acknowledge our humanness and each other's humanness, and that all of us are working on something, or all of us have something to work on, and that nobody is, nobody's free of it until we free ourselves of it. So we have to be the person who takes charge of our own life and our own destiny by working on these things and putting them into perspective and dealing with it directly. And that is really the only path towards, ultimate healing, I think. So anyway, I want to close our auric field. Bring all this forgiveness energy and all this thinking and contemplating through your auric field. Maybe the bad guys are actually good guys, and maybe the good guys are also good guys. I don't know. I don't know how it all works out for you, but I appreciate you. I'm wishing you well, and I will see you next week for a whole other series of practices around joy and sorrow, and we're going to bring the sorrow back into balance to get more joy and to bring more joy into our lives. So I hope you join me next week, and have a great night. Thank you for joining me. Bye.